Hi, so last time we saw what abstract classes meant, but I just said that abstractions are very important to principle, but I didn't really say what exactly abstraction meant. So abstraction is showing what is necessary and hiding the details. So in case of programming, it just means that we show the methods, what they return, what they expect as arguments, but we don't disclose how it was done, how the method does what it's supposed to do. So a very good example of this is when we see the documentations. You might have seen the official Java documentation by Oracle, and there what's going on is that what we see there is an interface. So we can see for any class all the methods it has, all the static fields that it has. So that's what abstraction would mean. And the way we create interfaces is something like this. Instead of class, we'll have interface. Interface is a Java keyword. Interface vehicle, let's say. And then it's just like a class. We would have fields and methods here. And we have created what would be a vehicle interface, and classes would implement this interface. So what an interface means is you could look at it as a template for a class. So that's what a vehicle is. It's an interface, and classes implement or realize an interface. So even in UML, we call it a realization relationship between the class and the interface. And there's a bunch of points that we need to remember for interfaces. So just like abstract classes, we cannot have instances of an interface. So but at the same time, we could have something like a vehicle V. But we cannot do something like vehicle V equals new vehicle. That would be wrong. And second, there's this thing about the fields and methods in an interface. So fields in an interface are public, static, and final. So I don't really have to mention any of these three. Even if I do something like int a, it would automatically be public, static, and final. And in fact, this thing that I've done right here is actually wrong, because since it is final, I need to do something like int a equals 1. This is a valid operation, because I'm setting a value to the variable, and that's what final variables are required to have a value. So that's the thing about fields. And about methods, the thing is methods are public and abstract. We talked about abstract methods in while talking about abstract classes. So abstract method means that there's no implementation, and there's no way that we can give an implementation to a method in an interface. So they have to be abstract, and they're also public. And this actually makes sense, because one very important application of interfaces is, let's say I'm giving my code to someone. I wouldn't want to give him the implementation of my method. So what I would do is I would make a bytecode from the class, and I could leave the interface as is and give that to the person so that he can look at the interface, but he can't read the bytecode for the class, so he doesn't know about the implementation. So the public part actually makes sense. And you'd also see something like interfaces achieve total abstraction or 100% abstraction. So that actually means that we're not giving away the implementation of anything, whereas abstract classes, they are said to have 0 to 100% abstraction. And that's because in an abstract class we could implement our methods, and in case we do implement all our methods, that would be 0% abstraction. And if we make all our methods abstract, that would more or less be an interface, so it's 100% abstraction. And another very important application of interfaces is that since Java does not allow multiple inheritance, we could, however, implement multiple interfaces. So classes can implement multiple interfaces. And in case classes do implement multiple interfaces, they must implement all methods in every interface that it's implementing, except if the class is abstract. So we can have an abstract class. So abstract classes can implement an interface and need not implement all methods. So in case we have an abstract class that implements an interface, we don't really need to implement all the methods. It's only when we create a concrete class from this, when we create a concrete class, only then do we have to implement all the methods. So that's actually a good use of interfaces. And another thing to remember about interfaces is that interfaces can extend interfaces. So I could do something like class class land vehicle, vehicle extends vehicle, and this could again have whatever we need. So we can create a hierarchy of implementations as well, and I think this wraps up the bunch of points that we need to remember for interfaces. That I'd just like to end with one point, which is that after JDK 9, Java allows private methods as well in interfaces. So private methods, also static methods. So these are things that it does allow. And one last thing, you might hear something called loose coupling, and interfaces are actually used to achieve loose coupling. But I'll talk about coupling later. There are two types of coupling, tight and loose, but let's go into that later. This is all about the points that I wanted to mention about interfaces, and making interfaces and implementing interfaces is something that we'll be looking at in the next video, which is going to be a programming session. So I'll see you there.